Hey, this is PCox. Welcome back to round two of a Dragons of Tarkir draft here on Channel Farball. This opening hand is basically the same as the last one. Pretty mediocre, but I don't think we can reasonably mulligan, so we'll keep. Yeah, it's exactly the same thing. It's, on the draw and with this guy, making him worse. I don't know. I think just playing a little with this guy, I'd yet to actually play with him or against him. It seems like there's definitely decks where he'd be very good if you have like multiple of the rebound plus two spell or just more bolster stuff, but I think he needs some help to be good, and so I don't think I should pick him super high because of that. All right, well, my opponent's TIE Fighter Rats. Maybe I'll keep playing nothing and then my captain will be amazing. Do you guys think that's likely? Probably not, but I will say, two-thirds of the guys in my hand are awesome against TIE Fighter Rats, just a bunch of first strikers. You got me for one. Do another color, see what else he's got going on. Mono black. Right, do we draw a two drop? Drew a guy. Cost five. It's not very good. It's kind of the same thing, right? It just seems so hard for someone to on turn four not be able to profitably block a 2/2 first strike. Morph. I think I just discard a land, right? Well, neither's super great. I could also just play Yearling. If I play this, he cannot attack with this 2/3 reasonably. I mean, he could have, if he has something else again, but can always play Yearling next turn if that doesn't work out. Plus some chance I just draw a pump spell or a bolster guy or a Doom Blast or something that makes this good, even if he's back a blocker. All right, blue black. So presumably an exploit deck, which have been pretty good in my experience so far. Okay. Yeah, so the question is, do I go ahead and play the Yearling and he can't, probably can't attack, or do I play this and threaten more damage? Probably this. That sounds better to me. This guy's a soldier, just to make sure, right? He's on a chariot with some rams or something. This guy's also riding one. Don't know much about magic flavor, but apparently human soldiers and warriors both ride ram things. What do you got over here? Something that's probably gonna outclass my stupid guys? Ah, crap. That card is so good. Oh, man. I'm just never attacking again. Eh, you probably could have. No, I guess you can't attack with that because they both have first strike. Well, 5/4 and 3/5 both really get in the way here, so that's good, I guess. Don't really know which is better, I suppose. If he's gonna have a removal spell potentially, I'd rather he kill my 3/5, I think. That guy was pretty good last game, so maybe I was underselling him. I guess I didn't really think about the fact that you can use his ability more than once. Like, if you can only use it once, it's fine. If it can turn into lure, that's a good bit better. He's just like kind of an awkward size. I mean, he would probably be too overpowered if he's, a 5'4" or whatever, but it's not too easy for him to eat guys. Let's just put on. Yeah, all right. Well, that's annoying. All right, you got me. I gotta take three. Well, guess we'll just play two things. Take that Void Squall. Not sure about that card. Like, bouncing two things is a powerful effect, but it's not at the same time, and five mana is a lot, so I could see it being good, I could see it being kind of mediocre. Like, I think an aggressive deck would rather have summons a lot of the time just because it's so much cheaper. Alright, so he bounced this guy, which, whatever, that's fine. I guess, like, maybe he's worried about me just attacking with both of these next turn, and, like, even if I trade off with that, this guy can't really be traded with, but it all means that depends on if he attacks with this or not, basically. I could put a lot of things in front of this and try and kill it, but that sounds like it could go pretty badly, so. Could have like a coat with venom or something here, or a butcher's glee, or nothing at all. I assume he has some kind of follow-up creature. Okay. Probably just play this. It's kind of the scariest thing I can be doing, right? Also means I can kill his 3/6. Like, he can't attack this 3/6. Like, it just doesn't. These kill it, and he can't blow me out. At least in his colors, really. Still probably losing that flyer unless something nice happens in the near future. What? All right, I'm probably gonna die to this strike. Need something good. I don't know what it is, but I need it. I didn't main deck that 6 mana gain a life and draw a card, or gain some life and draw a card, did I? I didn't. Is this guy an enchantment or artifact? He is not. All right, I'm dead. Guys, this Grave Titan guy is so good. All right. Well, again, I feel like I might or likely want Pinion Feast. I don't know if anything else here does a lot for me. Could also side this stupid thing out since I'm not sure it actually does much. Though I do think it's better on the play. Might be I'd side it out on the play and leave it on the draw. See, I don't know. I could see this eating some out of his guys. This might just be better than I thought it was. What do I take out? Yeah, probably this thing that I don't really. Sorry. This thing that I don't really like anyway. Alright. I'll keep, but I don't love it. Hope I draw some dragons. It's also possible I should have been like siding in those 3/2s for 3 and just trying to get aggressive, because he can certainly tempo me. He has some bounce, some tagum strikes, definitely ways to turn the corner, kind of, so don't want to give him time to do that. I think it drastically matters what we play first. I don't have any white-white or green-green guys. Don't know. There's a couple of green-green guys. I don't know if there's any white-white guys. Because there's the rare guy that like gets counters for guys with counters, and also the one where you reveal for if you have a dragon. It's uncommon. So I suppose it's technically right to play the forest first to represent that. But also, who the hell cares? I'm gonna guess he leaves his rats back to try and trade. No. What? Alright. Maybe this means he has something better to trade with this with, like if he has the I don't know. I was gonna say if he had the 1/1 that when he dies, you manifest, that'd be pretty good there. But he could have his defeat, it's 2 power, right? Not casting cost 2. Is that what it's called? Card's not very good. Probably shouldn't pick it. Well, if he has nothing, that play did not make sense. I'm gonna play this, and then he's gonna play a 2/3, and I'm gonna be like, why am I playing this card? Could have sided it out. Probably should have. I don't know. Just wanna, like, get some reps in with it, see if it's actually any good. But then it keeps appearing not to be. Alright, so let's discard planes. Yeah, like, without much delve, this guy seems pretty whatever. I mean, it's 2/3 for 3 is fine, but... Ooh. I can sandblast, and maybe over several turns my captain will be good enough to do anything. I'm not even sure if that's better than just playing more guys, but... We shall see. Might just not block. I'm really hoping for a not block, because I don't really want to spew my sandblast, but I felt like this guy doing nothing forever didn't sound like the best thing either, so. At least now if he plays like the 2/3 flyer next turn, then I can tack into it. It's like once you get the ball rolling, this guy's fine, but it takes some work. Like maybe I should have attacked with 3/1 and only attacked with that. I don't know. Alright, well. This is playing out as I expected, which is kind of weird because, like, what are the odds he plays exactly the same guys that he played last game, but... I guess maybe I also should have considered discarding Soul Summons just because I know I have several expensive guys in my deck, but if I don't draw them and then draw a bunch of lands, that's pretty bad too. Alright, well, it's like now that this guy is actually getting rolling, he is pretty good. Like, he's going to be a 4/4, and even the next turn I can still do it again. Well, I guess I'm not going to be able to do it again against my Soul Summons, but whatever. 4/4 first strike's pretty nice. He'll probably just bounce it now and I do all my work. That would not be a very nice thing for him to do. It's like, I hope you just play some different cards than you played last game, because all of the ones you played last game were good against me. What's this? It's the -3, so it probably just kills this, right? Assume you just sack this guy, like... Alright. I tried. It's actually, like, just traded a guy for a guy, so I guess it doesn't really matter that much, but... Yeah, I was gonna get my scale guard combo going with my crappy three drop again. Just dashed all my hopes and dreams here.
All right, what do you got?
Of all the things that could happen there, I'll take it. Could have Grave Titan, you could bounce a guy, like take five, whatever. We're almost in dragon territory too. So we get off this. I don't think that really affects if I play the land first. I don't know why I'm doing that, but curious. Ooh, actual creature. Daddy has any haste guys and is I could have dash guys, so I take back all that I said. But whatever. Can't imagine sending back's good. Tekken Strike is, I don't know, maybe I'm not giving enough credit. Like, I think it's playable. I would not play it in most black-blue decks because they're more exploit and controlling. But it's dealing 10 right now and could easily kill me, so. Kill me last game. If he didn't have that, I was in. I mean, I could lose to his flyer still, but I had, like, four more turns. Okay. See what he got. It's Delvin. It's like a Grimmag Angler or something, maybe. Ooh, Muck Draggers. That's annoying. Think it's probably correct to unmorph because this guy can trade with this guy. Okay. Well, was hoping to play a dragon. That kind of would turn things in my direction, but it's not to be, so see if we get anything good here. Man, I would way rather have drawn that. He's gonna play a flyer next turn. I could like kill his flyer and then my flyer is a 5/5 or a 4/4 or whatever and went pretty good. But no, now I just have a crappy 2/2. It's like if he plays that guy this turn, that's not horrible for me, but most other things he do are pretty scary. Like whatever, yeah, whatever he's doing is. All right. That Pinion Feast would have been real good. Stack even makes sense. I guess I could trade. I would be trading two guys, which is not great, but also don't even have to block. But I just block with my guy, my 2/4, and that just does nothing. Yeah. All right. God, I wish I had that Pinion Feast so bad. I don't think I can attack. All right, well, I'm not in horrible shape, but I'm not in good shape. I suppose I can attack with my dragon, and that's like somewhat decent. It's like if we trade. Okay. Maybe it's just bad. Just trying to think, like, I can always block my Sky Captain. Not any of these warriors. It's like a bird warrior or something. Well, it didn't matter because he's back that guy. But... Alright, so let's see what we got here. Ooh, a land. Yeah, that'll help things a lot. Well, I can attack with this, and if he blocks, my dragon can get bigger. And what I can actually do is put it on anything, it doesn't matter, and just make my dragon a 5/5, which is big enough. Though it could just be right to put them all on the dragon, I don't know. I don't know if that's great, but sounds okay. Sounds like it's doing more than it'll do right now. I guess it probably makes sense to put them all on this guy. Because then it has to be blocked next turn. So I guess the question is kind of what am I looking for? Like the plus two thing's pretty insane. Oh, I forgot it's Bolster. I'm sitting there thinking, what am I going to put counters on? I don't have any option on that. I'm stupid, and luckily, my scale thing is going to activate either way, because. Sitting here pondering where I put the. Yeah, okay. There's only one guy in the format who does that, and it's a 1/1 for one. All right, well, that puts a clock on me for sure. Okay. Well, I don't think attacking is going to do a lot for me. It's like I'll kill his noxious dragon, lose my guy, I lose another guy. Maybe I shouldn't. I probably should have not even attacked last turn. I forgot this did it when it came into play. So, yeah, I definitely think I screwed up the first game when I bolstered instead of just giving double strike to the guy. Also, I just F6 immediately right there, which was, I probably should have attacked. Because he would have had a block. So, overall, just tight play all around, you know? Alright, well, I'm dead. Man. I don't know why I didn't know. I guess I just, like, assumed I knew what this did and didn't actually read it. This is significantly better than I thought it was. Like, it's already good, but the ability to just have your two drop get in there for six is pretty awesome. So, whoops. All right, well, I am dead. Though this is Swiss, so I will see you guys next round. Woo.